It's the most beautiful thing in the world. But it's also connected to a deadly disease many people don't know about. Cervical cancer is caused mainly by a virus that spreads through sexual intercourse. According to the latest World Health Organization data, every year this disease kills more than 300,000 women worldwide. Especially in developing countries. This means that a woman is diagnosed with cervical cancer every minute, and a woman dies from cervical cancer almost every 2 minutes. Despite treatments being available for over a decade, cervical cancer seems set to continue claiming lives.
Cervical cancer is a late consequence of persisting infection with human papillomavirus. So most people catch the infection in their teens or early 20s, but it takes 20 to 30 years for a cancer to develop out of persisting infection.
Meet Ian Frazer. He's one of the reasons these numbers could be lowered. Together with his colleague and friend, the late immunologist Jan Su, Ian invented a vaccine against cervical cancer.
The vaccine works by inducing antibodies in the blood that can neutralize the papillomavirus, so that if somebody is subsequently exposed to the virus, they can't actually catch the infection. And if they don't catch the infection, they're not at risk of cervical cancer.
The invention goes back to the beginning of the 1990s, to the University of Queensland in Brisbane, Australia. Ian Frazer and Jan Su eventually tested out a completely new approach. They cloned the surface proteins of HPV and attached them to another virus that only served as a carrier. With their disguised virus, they were able to actually trick the human immune system into making antibodies against HPV. In response to the Trojan horse. The basic idea was born.
At the beginning, we did not realize it was going to be a game changer because we didn't really know enough about how common the virus infection was, how often it was involved in causing cervical cancer, and whether it would ever be practical to make enough vaccine to actually do something useful. But we had an idea that if there was going to be a vaccine to help prevent cervical cancer, our technology would be the way it would be done.
This moment marked the start of a success story. The vaccine was marketed in 2006, and in 2018 alone, it raised $3.2 billion. But from the very start, it was Ian Frazer's goal to reach the people in need. Administered via injection, the vaccine offers full protection against high-risk types of human papillomavirus. The latest HPV vaccine protects people from the 9 most dangerous types of HPV. To date, the vaccine has been dosed 270 million times, already saving the lives of tens of millions of women. In 2015, Ian Frazer and Jan Su, represented by his wife, were honoured with the European Inventor Award in the non-European countries category, making Ian a star virologist in Australia.
Being recognised publicly for science has enabled me to take a major role in helping to shape our Australian government's approach to health and medical research. I think that's actually been one of the big benefits, because now that I'm more interested in helping other people to get their research done, steering the research ship in Australia is something which is of practical use to the research community. It also helped persuade the government to set up a fund, the Medical Research Future Fund, specifically to fund research which is of practical implication for health.
And Ian's research is also on the agenda of the world's leading international health body, the World Health Organization. In May 2018, its Director General called for action. From now on, the WHO intends to eliminate cervical cancer across the planet within this century.
We're losing a woman every 2 minutes, and this should not happen, especially when we have all the weapons we need to fight it. Failure should not be an option.
because the toughest fight still needs to be fought, getting the vaccine to the people who need it. 9 out of 10 women who die from cervical cancer live in poor countries, even though vaccines and screening have made it one of the most preventable and treatable forms of cancer. But to eliminate the disease, the world has to act.
To achieve it in the developed world is a lot easier than in the developing world, where you have to actually develop vaccine programs to be given to girls aged 12 to 14. We don't have any routine health care that's given to 12 to 14-year-old girls in most of the developing world. So you have to build a program and then introduce the vaccine so you can get it distributed widely. Realistically, if we can achieve that over the next 10 to 20 years on a global basis, we will achieve our goal of eliminating cervical cancer by the end of the 21st century.
It would be the first time in the history of humanity that a form of cancer could be wiped out entirely.